Hello, ladies and gentlemen. It's Captain Chopper here.
Simply Kish.
And Mad Hatter.
Oh, hi there. This
very large hat that the captain was wearing.
And we are
going to
play some NBA.
This hat is too
on the,
I can't even see.
I'm on the right.
Okay. On the Grand Line Sports Zone.
That's correct.
Because I'll let you go on this one because this is your sport.
This
homie.
Is good for me, bad for not me, because it looks like, okay, I'm gonna.
Who am I being?
You are being the Cleveland Cavaliers.
In other words, someone that's not the Warriors. The
Cleveland Cavaliers.
Let's face it, the Warriors are amazing
this
year.
I cannot tell a lie. Call me George Washington. But
George Washington lied.
As of now, the Warriors aren't actually in the finals. Yeah. Well, they're going to be in the finals. They might as well be in the finals.
By the time this video is posted, they will be.
They're
going to
be in the finals. So, actually, I think the deciding game tipped off just about 20 minutes from recording this. Oops, my bad. But
it's plenty of time on this video.
Here's the thing. Let me tell you this thing really quick, guys. And gals, if you're watching. Here's the thing.
Lean on me now.
I've been watching the Warriors for several years now. I was a fan of the Warriors since before We Believe. That was the magical 2007 run when they were the number 8 seed and they upset the number 1 seed that had the MVP on their team that year.
Press start
to play. Am I choosing my...
I don't know.
I need to change my...
Well,
I'll just be interested this year. Oh no! Where's Draymond Green? Draymond Green is not in this game.
Oh my god! That is horrible!
Yeah, that's terrible.
Should we have a shout out to Bismarck in this one? He's going to be watching these games. I know he is.
Yeah.
Bismarck. Still doesn't like his name, but
Draymond
he's called Bismarck.
Draymond Green is not in this game.
Who's that?
Draymond, okay, let me first say this. It's kind of an older game. You will not see LeBron James on the Cleveland
Cavaliers. This is a 2-year-old game.
Yeah. So, LeBron James.
Oh, LeBron James is on the Cavaliers right now?
He is on the Miami Heat
right
now.
Dude, I love his bubblegum.
Isn't it?
It's good, good bubblegum,
really
yes.
King James.
This episode brought to you by LeBron James's Lightning Lemonade bubblegum.
I don't want that.
That shit is good.
No, it's not.
It's actually really good. It's really
so, bad. The Cleveland Cavaliers back in 2013.
The best lemonade is real lemonade.
Press start when you're ready.
Press
no, it's using
play.
Actual lemons in your
I have
water.
No idea how to play this game. What the fuck?
Oh, yeah, this is run by Jay-Z.
Yes.
Produced by Jay-Z. Yo,
the
Jay-Z.
Hell is Jay-Z?
He's a rapper.
Really?
Executive producer. Part owner of the Brooklyn Nets.
Oh.
The Nets?
The Nets.
Do they win?
They were half decent for a couple of years. I don't think they're decent now.
Doesn't Drake own a team right now or help out with a team or something?
The Toronto Raptors.
Oh, does he? Oh, yeah, that's right. He's from Canada.
Canada. So.
How are his legs doing?
How his legs?
Yeah.
You're the worst. You're a terrible person. So, Kyrie Irving,
yes.
Dion, who cares about these guys? Because they're not LeBron James.
Okay.
The Cleveland Cavaliers are entering their first finals.
It's a white guy with afro.
Yeah, he's pretty good, actually. Oh, it's not bad. He's an energy player. So, the Cleveland Cavaliers are entering their first finals since LeBron James left Cleveland.
Okay.
LeBron James is going to his 5th straight NBA Finals appearance.
Huh.
As a Cleveland Cavalier, maybe he could finally restore sports to Cleveland.
Oh, look at that. Tim Curry's getting like, he's...
Steph Curry?
Sure.
Yes.
No, Tim Curry.
Steph Curry, the MVP of the league.
The guy from Rocky Horror.
Oh.
Rocky Horror?
Yeah.
I'm Chef
Tim
Curry.
Curry
right now.
Jim Curry?
So, I'm sorry. Let me answer your question. Who is Draymond
Curry?
Green? Draymond Green is a rookie that joined the Rockets the year after this. I'm Splash Brothers, so I'm just going to shoot it.
I wish we were playing Space Jam. I could play that.
Yeah.
Space Jam.
Making it rain. Splash. So, Draymond Green is the runner-up for Defensive Player of the Year this year. But the thing is, the way that those postseason awards go, they get voted on by a panel of writers and broadcasters.
Okay.
How do I freaking... Oh, gosh.
Oh my gosh.
What the...
Nice.
Knowing Curry, he could have made that in real life. He
really?
Did make one of those in real life.
Did he?
He did?
Yeah.
During a game?
Oh, my God.
Yeah, during the last playoff series against Memphis. Or that's round 2. So, Draymond Green, he won. Not won, he won 2nd place. But he had the most 1st place votes. You get 5 points for every 1st place vote you get. You get 3 points for every 2nd place.
How do I shoot?
Square. Circle, I think.
God damn it.
You made it.
Oh,
did
nice.
I?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh,
but
shot clock counted
it?
Oh.
No. Is that Brian Shaw? Is that your coach? That's funny. Alright, let's do this.
Why is it funny?
Because he...
Explain to the audience who don't understand basketball.
Well, even if you do understand basketball, you don't want Brian Shaw. So let's see. So square is to shoot, I think.
Okay.
I just pressed square and I shot. I could spitball Warriors facts all night.
Could you?
Yeah. Stephen Curry is the MVP.
Shoot.
And in the second... No, actually.
You were close.
Oh!
Nice.
First
blood. Well, no. Simply Kish got first blood.
Yeah. But.
So, reach and foul. Is X to pass? Because I'm passing, but it's not working.
You could pass it. I think it's... Oh.
Circles to pass?
Yeah.
I think you guys should act very aggressive and as I did and go... Ah! Ah!
You know who we really have to have on the Grand Line Sports Zone at some point?
Bismarck?
Sneath.
Oh, there it is. I know, right?
He would be giving us all the facts.
Yeah, oh.
Like this guy right here, David Lee?
Not in European sports.
He is a former All-Star.
Actually, Sneath has watched a little bit of soccer. He wouldn't be giving you all the facts, but he would be giving you some facts.
I would rather...
Traveling!
Wait, why? From Missouri.
Yeah. Traveling is when you walk with the ball without dribbling.
Is it?
Yeah.
I didn't know.
I did not know. I assume traveling is when you go to an airport and go to a different country.
No. That's not traveling. Traveling is when you... Chef Curry cooking? Nope. Oh, David Lee with the cleanup. So David Lee is a former All-Star for the Warriors. He was injured at the beginning of this season, so Draymond Green, his replacement, stepped in.
You have 18 seconds to score.
Draymond Green actually stole his starting spot.
Go!
David Lee's not even part of the rotation.
Pass!
So, that's a...
Did you make it? No, you didn't make it.
Ooh,
you were close.
Do that.
Well, since we're on basketball and Sneath...
David Lee! Another bank!
I'm bringing back the Sneath.
The Sneath?
Is that I wanted to say, we've had some good times... with basketball at school.
Yes, we did. That was fun.
I remember our good old friend,
Lardo,
as he's not going to be...
Lardo!
Press the wrong button.
He was known in our high school for the cough.
Should we do it? We're on camera. We can do it.
All right. It's funny because his cough are so loud that even in an auditorium... anyone could hear it.
Well, in an auditorium...
You have good acoustics.
Wait, what?
In an auditorium, it would be even louder because you have good acoustics.
Thing is, it's incredibly loud. Anywhere he is, everyone's like, there's a Lardo. He will suck
there's
at...
There's a Lardo. Not
he
one.
He will suck at hide and seek.
Multiple ones.
There's the Lardo.
Yeah, I mean, it was so infamous that we made up a dance for it at prom.
What he meant by me...
Woo!
Well, I made a lot of dances, like
you
the umbrella.
Did. Yes, you did.
Yes.
You know, like that undersign, the whatever umbrella, something with the umbrella.
As we
you
are now, say, we were infamous
you can
in high
stay
school
under
for
my
being
umbrella,
weird, I feel like.
Ella, okay.
Except for Simply Kish, who was cool for, like, junior high.
Move art now.
Simply Kish was cool at junior high.
Too early.
I thought Simply Kish was a douche.
That's why he was cool.
Yeah. That's how it works. Add all the right friends in junior high.
So what happened?
He started becoming friends with you.
Yeah, he started hanging out with the band geeks.
Oh, that's
true.
Too
early.
Let's face it.
Freaking Curry.
That's true. He started hanging out with me, and I was one of those kids who ate glue.
You did?
No. Of course not. If anything, I was trying to sell drugs, even though it was probably grass.
So once you pick up your dribble, you are not allowed to dribble again.
Why is there so many white guys?
Yeah, I thought this was a black man sport.
Every sport is a black man sport.
No, it doesn't involve
water.
Have you seen soccer? That's a Spanish sport. That's a Brazilian sport. That's a European
I don't know.
Sport.
I saw a lot of South Africans on there a year ago.
Ooh, nice.
Did I not?
I can name you a team and they won't have more than five black men.
Clay Thompson.
No, okay, I'm pretty sure they have more than five, but that's including... There's no team that's dominated by black
NBA,
men's, okay?
Nothing but Africa.
The two sports where black man just dominates is basketball and track and field.
All right.
I mean, have you seen a 100-meter run where at least two-thirds of the 100-meter run
is
black
man? Oh, no! Oh, my gosh! Beadrinx is on this team?
I didn't mean to do that.
Oh, no.
Who?
Andres Beadrinx.
Him?
No, my guy. He's from Latvia.
Is that bad?
Andres Beatrice is bad.
Is he game seven?
No.
Who's that?
That's Zaza Pachulia.
Is he still playing basketball?
I'm not sure.
Is he good?
He was all right.
What about Dikembe?
He's very good, yes. Dikembe is probably one of the top 50 players of all time.
Wait, how's it pronounced?
Dikembe Mutombo.
Dikembe Mutombo.
Oh, Barnes with a rebound.
Where is he from?
Dikembe Mutombo?
Yeah.
Probably from like Uganda.
Uganda.
Carl Landry.
You know, I want to say, okay, back on a serious note.
Hey,
it's going to be
hey.
The Cleveland Pistons?
Cavaliers.
Whatever.
Pistons.
They're the inferior team.
Yes.
They against have one player. The Warriors.
Here's the thing. This is the Warriors' best chance to win. Because the Cleveland Cavaliers are injured right now. They're missing their big season offseason acquisition in Kevin Love. Kyrie Irving, their number two option, just came back from an injury last game. And LeBron James is struggling with a couple problems himself. The Cleveland Cavaliers are banged up. Big time.
Oh, man, all right, so well, what do you predict the scores will be? Like, how much of a gap?
It's going to be, I think, Warriors in six, maybe seven.
Six or seven.
Because, dude, even the Warriors, everything's falling into place for them. Their biggest, because the Western Conference is far superior to the Eastern Conference.
So you're saying it's like an 8-2 chance the Warriors will win.
What are you talking? Oh, yes. I think there's a very good chance. I read a couple articles where they asked professional writers and analysts who do they think is going to win. And 9 out of 9 said the Warriors.
9 out of 9.
Wow.
Wow. I mean, we cannot deny on how much of an influence that has.
9 out of 9 dentists agree.
Yep.
Yeah, they agree. Well, what is it usually like?
10-4.
4 out of 5.
That's a high scoring game.
4 out of 5 dentists agree that chewing gum.
In one quarter?
Actually, wouldn't they be scoring more than that usually?
Yeah.
Oh, hell yeah. At least 2 times.
25.
We're just not good at this game.
Yeah. Whatevs. The Warriors have outscored the Cleveland Cavaliers by 4.6 points.
Anyway, we could definitely say the biggest reason for the success of the Warriors has to do a lot with Curry, right?
Stephen Curry has been playing like an MVP all season. See, the thing is, when they signed him, when they did sign him to the extension, people were kind of iffy about that because he had ankle problems. I think this is the first time he played all season, but that's regardless of the point. He had injury problems. So when they signed him, it was very, risky. And now it's proving out to be the steal of the NBA.
What the fuck?
Freaking.
I know how it feels. Like, you know, you just bought a player, you don't know if he'll live up to it, and then, wow, he's a dynamite.
He far supersedes it. He is by far the best shooter in the NBA. And arguably probably the best shooter in NBA history.
Wow, that's saying a
lot. This past season, he broke his record for most three-pointers made in a single NBA season. He broke his own record.
Is it kind of like a, what's his name, in football? The 49ers quarterback,
Joe Montana?
No, not Joe Montana.
Steve Young.
No, the current.
Current quarterback, Kaepernick?
Yes. Kaepernick, yes.
No, he's much better than Kaepernick.
Well, no, I'm just saying, remember Kaepernick? Like, everyone thought, like, oh, he's just a newbie, and then, you know,
I thought it was the opposite for Kaepernick, to be honest. Thought everyone thought he was going to be really good, and then he was kind of
Yeah, that's exactly what happened.
No, I thought it was more like, you know, until the Bears game where he made his debut, that's where he wowed everyone, and then after the first year, he kind of declined.
Yeah. What point are you trying to make?
He's comparing Curry to Kaepernick.
Well, I'm just saying, like, you know, Kaepernick was considered a steal in the beginning of his career.
They drafted him knowing he was going to be the starter. He was a second rounder.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't know sports as well as I thought.
So I don't want to say he was a steal because he still actually hasn't lived up to it. He had one good season because...
Yeah, that's true.
No one knew exactly what was going to go on.
That is true. I guess it's just...
I mean, technically, the Niners got to the Super Bowl twice, but...
Once.
Oh, I thought they got in twice.
It was just once.
No, once.
It was disappointing.
Yeah.
That was our best time, and he choked.
Yeah, he did. No, he didn't choke.
He choked.
They were one possession away from winning.
No, they
weren't.
They
were one frame goal at the 1 yard line from winning.
They were not.
Yeah, they were.
No, it felt very one-sided, that game.
It did, but they still had a chance to win. They chose to throw the ball on fourth down. That's their problem. That was more of a game coaching than it was an actual Kaepernick problem, I think. But whatever, that's besides the point. It's all in the past. We're playing basketball now.
That is true. Where Curry is a steal.
Stephen Curry is trying to be the first NBA player in history. Okay, so one of the postseason awards is called the All-NBA Team. I don't know if other sports do that. But at the end of the year...
Did you see that? You knocked me over. Why ain't I got no call on that?
Like an all-star team?
Yeah.
Like
at the end of the year.
Let's say there is a interracial. Okay, interplanetary basketball game.
I'm sorry.
Earth were to have a basketball team, they would want.
Can we not skip over that? Matt Hatter just said interracial basketball. I'm pretty sure it's been interracial for a pretty long time now,
Oh, yeah, it has. Okay, but let's say...
Interspecies. Is what you meant to say, correct?
I meant to say interspecies.
As in, like, aliens and shit.
Yes.
Okay, let's say... Dog people. They were supposed to have a team for Earth, to represent Earth in a basketball team.
Yes.
So that's what you're saying.
Yeah. You'd have Michael Jordan from when he was younger.
Pick, at the end of the year, they'll pick the best center, the best power forward, the best...
Yeah, every sports have that. Like, okay, I don't know about hockey.
Yes, we do. There's an all-star game for hockey.
But is there an all-hockey team at the end of the year?
No. There are MVPs and stuff like that, but I don't think there's... There's, like, best players and stuff like that, but I don't think there's a...
Why is Beavers on the same court as Bogut?
So, we know that Curry is going
to Stephen Curry did make the NBA All-First Team, and he's trying to be the first player in NBA history to successfully beat every other NBA First Team in the playoffs. The NBA All-Star First Team is consisted of Stephen Curry on the Warriors.
Yes.
He is trying to... He beat the power forward NBA All-First Team, Anthony Davis, in the first round.
Okay.
He beat the center... during the next round in Memphis Grizzlies.
Nice.
He's beating the shooting guard in the third round against the Rockets, and when he beats LeBron James, he will have successfully beat all of the other NBA All-First Team NBAers. The first player in history to do that.
So, let's say he's successful and has done so,
yes,
he will be considered the most successful basketball player of all time.
I won't say the most successful, but he did succeed at doing something that not even Michael Jordan has done.
That is surprising, because everyone knows who Michael Jordan is, even if you don't know basketball.
So, yeah.
But will he be in that level of fame? Like Michael Jordan status?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
I don't know about that. He's not Curry isn't going to be in, like, movies and stuff, I don't think.
No.
Well, no, because he has a career right now.
He's already stealing the show from LeBron James as probably the face of the NBA. He's going down history.
I think right now he kind of...
He's going down history as one of the best shooters, if not the best shooter of all time. NBA, freaking every time too early.
But I mean, you can't say that Curry is going to be the next Michael Jordan.
Well, no.
They're different players. No, but Michael Jordan was...
Not only that, in different eras. I mean,
yeah.
Michael Jordan, he created his legacy when he was at his, what you call it, his prime. Now this is Stephen Curry's
It's a different
era.
Game. It's centered around the three-point shot.
I was going to say, bring up a good
exactly,
point.
That's another thing.
He's
very successful in his three-point.
Yes.
Like, you know, very accurate.
He is a three-point challenge or a champion right now in the NBA All-Star Weekend, so...
I mean, he makes it look easy.
Yes,
he does. And that shit's hard.
Yes. He makes it... There was a video out there where they have him shooting, I think, 90-something... No. It was, yes, he went 90s,
oh, nice.
Maybe 92 out of 100 shooting three-pointers.
92 out of 100?
Something like that. He made like 40-something in a row.
Oh, my God.
On video. So, end of the second, 26-9.
I was going to say, if you had a basketball dream team, who would it be? Who would you put on it?
I would put...
For one squad, not like the whole thing.
For all NBA?
Yes, over
like
all time.
All legends.
Yes.
So, I would put...
Can I put out ones that I think you're going to say first?
Yes.
Other than Jordan, because most people would do him.
Yes.
Larry Bird. Would you do the Bird?
No.
Really?
Because he plays the same position as LeBron James, I think. Small forward.
And you would take LeBron over.
I'll put LeBron James over, yeah.
After that, I can't think of any, because I only know Larry Bird and Michael Jordan for
I'll put Magic Johnson as my point guard.
Shaq.
I would not put Shaq. He's definitely one of the most dominating centers, but if I had to pick a center, it'd either be Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Oh, yeah, I've heard of him.
Okay. Or Wilt Chamberlain.
I've heard of him, too, yeah.
He scored 100 points in a single game.
Oh my god.
And he slept himself? With more women on the same night. That's the rumor.
And Magic Johnson fixed AIDS by having lots of money.
Yes. He's actually very inspiring by coming back to play in the NBA after he was diagnosed with AIDS. It was a very good moment in NBA history.
I finally made a shot.
It'll be a lot better if he didn't sleep with a lot of women.
He's a point guard, and when his starting center got injured, he started at center. So that's how versatile that guy is.
Ah, son of a bitch.
So I put Magic Johnson, yes. Irvin Magic Johnson, Michael Jordan as my shooting guard, LeBron James as my small forward. Who would my power forward be? Probably Tim Duncan. Yeah, I'm going to put Tim Duncan. Because I can't think of who else there is.
In the comments, let's have that as our little question of the day, or all our right. like thing of the day. Who would you make your basketball dream team?
I think that should be a question of the day for any sports.
Yeah.
Oh, 5 seconds. You only have five seconds.
I didn't realize what was going on.
Mark Jackson. Okay, here's a fun fact. Mark Jackson is the old coach of the Warriors. He used to be a commentator / broadcaster before he became the coach.
Oh, so he's the opposite of John Madden.
Yeah, I guess. So he's a coach right now. This past season, he got fired, and he got replaced by the voice you hear on the screen right now, Steve Kerr.
What happened? Why am I
You
mad?
Got fouled, so you got and one, so you get a free throw as well. Okay. So, Mark Jackson, throughout the whole playoffs, or at least throughout this whole last round, had to watch his former team in the playoffs. He had to commentate over his former team.
What am I doing here?
You're shooting. Just move your right stick down like that, and up.
Okay.
So, just flick it.
So, there's, on
Do
ESPN...
Do I have to press square, or is it
No, just down and up. On your other side. The other analog stick. Slightly early.
Oh, nice.
There it is. So, that's how you do it.
Nice, man.
All right. So,
I'm still not going to win this game.
In ESPN, Mark Jackson and this other commentator, Jeff Van Gundy. I'm not
going to. Oh, okay. I didn't know what was going on.
They were both former coaches, now broadcasters. Mark Jackson was a former coach of the Warriors. Jeff Van Gundy was a former coach of the Rockets. And they are both now commentating, watching their former teams duke it out as a chance to enter the NBA Finals.
So are they mad?
No, they're not allowed to be mad. You need to be professional. But it was funny.
Are they personally mad?
Probably, I don't know.
Can I bring up something non-basketball related really quick?
Only if it's really quick.
Okay, it'll be really quick. So,
I'm giving 5 seconds.
Chin Chin Sacrifice came out recently. We were not on it, but he brought up a good thing at the end. And that's the true treasure is not the sacrifice, but making fun videos with your friends.
Okay.
And we had, I would say we had a decent amount of fun making our Chin Chin Sacrifice video.
It was fun, I guess.
I think next time if we do, we should actually smoke some pot.
What?
I don't know.
We didn't
even
smoke pot there.
Come on, I'm assuming everyone smoked pot when they were making their video, so it's only fair if we get our ideas, we should smoke some pot.
To be honest, I think most of them were just weird white people in the South.
Oh, they are so weird. They are like from Wisconsin.
That was a pretty good one, haven't it?
You could tell they...
I'm Steph Curry, I have to make this.
Yeah, they're just weird.
Freaking Stephen Curry. Oh, is that and one again?
I'm trying to go for those layups. I'm trying to go for those layups.
That's how it's done. So, Clay
Thompson. Try.
What do you remember from our high school days of playing basketball on the courts?
Ooh, there's one thing I remember. When Simply Kish,
nice.
The Albit, and
yes,
Blackie Chan.
Oh, okay.
When those three took on three girls in a basketball game,
whoa, they had a threesome?
To be fair, one of them was on the girls' basketball team. So
it was so one-sided.
Who was on the girls' basketball team? Really?
Yes.
Damn, she's multi-talented.
Wait, who?
The artist. I mean, I know they're all artists, but I know exactly... You know who I'm thinking of.
Yes, the artist, the one who could stare through my soul and crush it.
That is it.
And then the kindness one.
What?
The kindness one.
Yes, one of the twins.
Oh, yes, okay.
Fingers McGee.
Oh, you're the worst. You are a terrible person. Steph Curry cooking it up.
It was so one-sided on them.
Steph Curry.
The thing is, I'm assuming the one who could stare through my soul and crush it and the one of the twins.
Why wasn't Lulu really good at basketball?
And I can understand the one who plays at basketball is the talented one. You know.
Very multi-talented.
Oh, yeah. And then we have the Albe, who is freakishly tall.
Yes.
Blackie Chan, who's black.
So he should be good and at basketball,
Simply
right?
Kish, who knows how to play basketball. I assume all three, like, three decent against one good with two. I don't think they've ever played basketball before.
Who?
And
oh, that was a nice shot, yeah. I'm sure the girls had played basketball before, just not that much, and maybe not against...
All right, but
against, as tall guys.
Against Flash and Chan and Dialba and Simply Kish, I assume, okay, maybe a close game, but it was a one-sided game.
Were you even there?
No, not really.
Yeah, this do you know how freaking one-sided it was?
I heard the score, and I only assume it's very
If we're
going to
make fun of people, let's also talk about Mad Hatter over here when he tried to get me to tackle him in a football-type
Whoa.
Exercise.
That is something for football-relatedness.
Football-type exercise, and then fell flat on his face. But not only that.
First of all, if you're going to play football, try tackle.
And don't do it on cement. Because
why not?
That was your problem when you fell flat on your face.
Did I die?
Yes.
Oh, I died?
Yes.
Oh, shit.
You have 9 lives like a cat.
How about the one where you try to shoot a layup, hit the rim, and hit you in the face?
Shut up, okay? I am not a basketball. I am very clumsy with the hands.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, are you? Then?
I am really clumsy with the hands.
Sorry, ladies.
Yes. You'll be having a really weird orgasm.
Like you're not sure what to do. You're going to be like,
I'm
not sure if this feels good.
I mean, it feels weird. I mean, a good weird or a bad weird?
I don't know.
You're just weird.
Oh my gosh.
Beyond weirds. Up. Dude, we're just going up and down now.
Yeah.
So, people are saying...
Isn't that part of the game, though?
That's the way that the Warriors like to play.
So, what were we talking about before we got to the weirdness of us?
Of orgasms?
Of weird orgasms,
we're talking
yes,
about basketball. Before. And people are saying, I don't know, do you want to talk about NBA again? Because I kind of do.
Sure, yeah.
People are saying it's hard for... You got 5 seconds again.
I don't... I thought he'd just do it automatically, but whatever. Guess not.
Have you heard the adage that offense wins games, defense wins championships?
No.
I do agree with that saying.
Nice shot.
In it. In it to win it. Have you heard that... you can stop playing basketball and join the theater club.
Who said that? I know. Okay. I know exactly. I got my head in the game.
Do you?
Yeah.
Do you think Curry has his head in the game?
Yes. And that's funny because just the other day...
Or does he gotta get his head in the game?
He actually suffered a pretty scary head injury.
Did he?
Yeah, he fell on his head.
Ooh.
He went for a block. And then the guy went for a pump fake, and then he totally fell over and landed on his head. He used his hand.
Brought to you by Sprite.
Yeah.
Brought to you by Sprite.
There it is.
The Sprite.
You better quench that thirst.
Quench your thirst. That's not Sprite. Is that Sprite? I thought that was Gatorade.
Oh, really?
I don't know.
Can you quench your thirst with LeBron's Lightning Raspberry Lemonade?
No.
How about Shaq Soda?
Yes, you can. I've heard that's not bad. Some people have said...
Or is it Shaq tea or something like
that? They have both, actually.
Shaq iced tea.
Oh, wait,
you go and get Shaq.
I'm sorry, it's Shaq's...
Shaq and the Fool.
No, Shaq's Hard Lemonade.
It's Shaq Soda and Shaq...
Hard Lemonade.
And Shaq...
you go and get Shaq.
God damn it, what is it?
Shaq.
It's not tea and it's... I don't think it's lemonade, but I'm not sure. Oh, punch, like fruit punch.
Ah. Oh my jeez! Come on, Bogut.
Do you remember back in the day going to Chuck E. Cheese and playing the basketball game?
No.
Yeah.
Did you ever do
that? I know
that
Dave & Buster's was the adult Chuck E. Cheese. In fact, I did that yesterday.
The adult Chuck E. Cheese with strippers.
Ooh, how did
and
I sneak in?
Nah.
With hookers and blackjack.
I wish.
You know what? Forget the Chuck E. Cheese. Just go with the hookers and the blackjack.
In fact, screw you all.
For 20 tickets.
You'll get a lap dance.
A really shitty one, because the good ones are 60 tickets.
Yeah, they're in an animal suit.
Ooh, that's just weird. Daniel Gibson, your shooting guard?
Yeah.
His nickname is Booby.
About some
is
really
it?
Booby Gibson.
Uncharted weird.
Why is it that?
Yeah, he got that name.
Did we have nicknames for people 52. On our basketball team?
Are you talking about the Warriors? Or
our high school football basketball team.
I don't know.
our school football team. Come on. Our high school didn't have football.
Now it does. Our school now has...
I thought that got shot down again.
Yeah, it did.
It did?
Yeah. The coach like took the money and ran.
Really?
And then they didn't have any more money for football, so they're like, oh, well, forget football, I guess.
Well, why would you? I mean, our school had so many Asians. Like those Bobby Asians. Those really weak-ass Asians.
What does it have to do with football?
Woo! They cannot take a tackle shot for the life. Yeah. They get tackled. I know their principal soon. You need
10 more like that.
I know.
Let's face it. I'm just being honest. I'm pretty sure those guys got tackled.
That is a prettier shot.
Their parents will sue. Say that. Why is my son not doing more math homework?
Booby Gibson. Thompson.
I thought the big thing at our school was the biotech. Or the robot club.
It was a biotech lab.
That was a pretty good hype.
We were the only school, I don't know if we still are, that had a biotech
probably lab. Probably not.
I know, probably about 4, 5, 6 biotechnology.
But
it was nice to have that program.
Around my house, they have an aquarium for like marine biology shit.
Well, look at you.
Well, our school doesn't even have a marine biology. It just has biology where they also teach evolution.
I thought they didn't teach evolution in our
biology. Oh, yes, they don't, because, you know, they're creationism. It's a very creationist.
Don't we talk about...
Dude, white guy with the afro has actually been doing really good. I mean,
yes, people.
Yeah.
He went to a weird high school.
Is he?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
He's the one that... You have, obviously, your skill players, your shooters. You have the ones that are big in the inside, the defensive players. Your energy players are just the one that play with heart.
Who's big on the outside?
The one that... What do you mean? Like, on the outside perimeter? Side. Oh, you're the worst. No, your energy players are the ones that are...
Shit.
Yeah.
You're having that problem too, huh?
Yeah. Always too early. I have that problem all the time. But they're the ones who will die for the ball. They're the ones who will go up hard in the paint.
Push somebody?
Yeah.
Like in hockey?
They're the ones that start a fight.
Like in hockey?
Yeah.
Where everyone just starts a
fight.
Yeah,
that's the...
Is there actual fights in basketball?
They're called brawls, and they happen.
Send people to jail for 2 days.
No.
No, man. Just because they're black doesn't mean they all go to jail.
Oh. A lot of the Raiders go to jail.
Oh, because they're from Oakland, dude.
I thought a lot of the Raiders... Don't we get most of our players from jail?
No. Whoa. No. Wait, what?
I said, don't we get most of our Raiders players
nice
from jail?
Pass.
Yeah, no, but what did Simply Kish say?
I know, it was good. It was good.
Yes, it was a great pass. Went all the way across the court.
Nothing easy.
Ooh, after this guy.
Game 7! Nothing easy!
Freaking the Hawks. He was on the Hawks, and the Hawks just got eliminated by the Cavs.
Are we going to see a score similar to this, but let's say times 2?
64-37?
Hell no.
64-39? That's what, a 25-point difference?
The Cavs will do better than this.
Actually. Oh my gosh! Charles Jenkins! That's hilarious. I forgot he was on this team once upon a time.
Well, we won't say 39-66, but more like 78-132.
Well,
oof. Monster rebound.
That was a monster block.
We're not going to see that.
How did you guys used to say that back on the basketball court? Didn't you have a way of saying that?
It was a marquee matchup. Monster rebound, yeah.
Yeah.
But no.
Damn white people saying the darndest
things. The
Warriors
just... Well, in their last round against the Rockets, they beat the Rockets by like 25, 30 points on the Rockets' home court. So,
wow,
the Warriors could shoot their way into victory, which I want to get this out of the way really quickly. The Warriors are the best shooting team in the league, like by far.
Are they?
Oh, I'm not surprised.
Stephen Curry is the best Stephen Curry and Klay Thompson. They're called the Splash Brothers because they make the bottom of the bottom of the net go splash.
Do you think Stephen Curry eats curry?
Yes. His wife is a cook.
Oh, is she?
Really?
Yeah, she has her own cooking show. That's why he gets the nickname Chef Curry.
What's it called?
I never heard of that.
Cooking with Curry? I don't know. His wife's name is Aisha.
Is it?
Aisha.
Is she black?
Of course. With a name like Aisha?
I'm racist as fuck.
Well, of course you're racist as fuck. Okay, you're white.
People are saying
this is true.
That the...
I have white privilege.
Ooh, bonus.
He has white privilege, okay?
Let's see if I can make an actual
blaze above in that bullshit.
Not only that, I'm an average white
too
man
early still?
In America. So hold it a little bit longer. And
yeah.
Then, like, hold it longer than
Whoa,
you think.
Why are you helping him? Okay, you're already losing that battle.
Yeah, exactly. I'm not going to win.
So, try to...
Okay.
See, there you go.
There you go. I like it.
Ah.
You know what we should play at some point?
Oh, look! Simply Kish, you got a 69!
Michael Jordan versus Larry Bird free point contest. It's a game for the Super Nintendo.
Michael Jordan, Larry Bird.
I don't think it's a free point contest. I think it's an actual, like, half court game. But.
Like, can I join that competition? In fact, I won't even come close someday.
You don't come close a lot of the time.
I'll probably kick it.
Oh, Beatrice is holding
Should we record over the summer? We used to have our tradition of going to Albert's house and playing basketball. Should we record over the summer a basketball game?
That'd be hilarious.
At the
I will Albert's be shirtless. House.
Could we get pretty salty, man?
We do.
Well, at least I got really salty.
I know. Bismarck,
you guys do.
Yeah.
Bismarck got really salty.
Oh, yeah.
A few times. He gets really salty at his brother because his brother actually plays basketball.
Mm-hmm.
His brother plays in the Splash. High school team.
We can get cosplayer N in on it.
But cosplayer N actually knows how to play. I mean, he's definitely better than me.
And Electric it's sad Spider to say, but he's better because he's tall.
Wait, who?
Electric Spider. He's
Electric Spider.
He's cosplayer N's like best friend right now.
He doesn't know the Albert, so
making it rain.
I mean, the Albert kind of hates cosplayer N as it is, but
not Wario though. I mean, he could come, but
no, Wario has to.
Does he?
Yes, he has to.
And that's the game.
That's the game.
And the Warriors are going to beat the Cavaliers in the finals.
I know Slaughter Melon sucks. Slaughter Melon just sucks. He is tall.
Stephen Curry, MVP.
I mean, he's as tall as the Albert, and he just sucks.
So this has been a pretty long episode. We're going to have a couple of these right now, because we're going to have the horrible Lee shot that we did NHL finals, because I messed up. I fucked up, guys. And
you fucked up really bad.
And forgot that we still had one more game until we get, or a couple more games till we get to the actual Stanley Cup Finals. But it's probably going to be the Blackhawks versus the Rangers, and I'm still going for the Blackhawks.
Wait, the Ducks aren't going to the finals?
It's 1-3 right now.
So no on the Ducks.
No, if the Blackhawks win, I think one more game, they get to go to the finals. It's either 1 or 2. I can't remember.
I will say
it's
this.
Best of 7. So
yes,
one.
One more game.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we're still going for the Blackhawks, though. But that was still a fun game. I'll be hopefully editing that and posting that up tonight, which is why I'm wearing my Sharks jersey right now. We sucked.
I'm not. I wish I had my Warriors gear.
No, this is a Warriors gear. See, okay. It's blue and white. Yeah, it's good.
I wear my Warriors gear when we play soccer.
Anyways.
All right.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
And I'm still going to crush you.
We got back from Fanime fairly recently, so our regular scheduled programming of, you know, four video game videos a day should be back up within the next week or so. And we're
You'd be killing yourself if you put up 4 videos a day.
And we're also going to have...
Well, you know, some people could do that.
I know.
And we're also going to have some extra stuff. We're going to be having our summer music playlist competition.
That's right. That's going to be released next week.
As well as we're going to be having, you know, a bunch of other fun stuff. Me and Matt Hatter want to do some cooking.
Even though I can't cook for shit.
There's going to be some cosplay stuff coming up. I actually recorded one already. And lastly, I'm going to just say, go Warriors.
Go Warriors!
Yeah.
I'm actually rooting for the Warriors, too.
Go Warriors.
As you should.
Because ever since that game where, you know, Curry, thanks to him, they overcome a 20-point deficit.
In the first round against the Pelicans?
I'm sorry, that won my heart.
Hashtag.
Curry, you won my heart.
Hashtag, give me some Curry.
Just like you won your wife's heart. Okay, not like that, but hey.
Hashtag, give me some Curry.
Oh, man.
And also, in the comments, tell us...
Your
all-star team for basketball. And we will see you next time on Grand Line Sports Zone.
Da-da.
If you want to see more of these awesome videos from Captain Chopper and the crew, please like,
comment,
subscribe,
and share.
Share.
Yeah, I mean, it's really... Sharing is caring.
Yeah.